All right, let me break it down for you. It's 2010, and I think I'm the shit. I'm a 12-year-old punk who skateboards, stole Justin Bieber's haircut, maxed out my Facebook friend limit, and tells everyone at school that I smoked weed before. Which, of course, is a lie, but everyone always believes it because I just look like I smoke weed. But really, I just end up doing a bunch of other stupid things that get me in trouble. Which then leads to me being at home all the time, watching movies. And just at the right time in my life, I happen to watch one of the very few perfect movies that have ever been made. You see, that year, a movie came out called The Social Network, and this movie would impact an entire generation of future programmers. Erica Albright is a bitch. And then he goes on to drunkenly hack housing directories and builds a viral app that crashes Harvard's network all in a single night. I mean, come on, he makes programming look cool as shit in this movie. When the movie ended, I got up and ran to my home computer to Google how to write code. As if I'm gonna learn it in fucking 10 minutes. So no, I didn't learn how to write code in 10 minutes, but what I did learn is that if you control click on your browser, and then you click inspect element, you can edit the content of a web page. Now at the time I didn't know this was HTML, I just thought it was code, but when I found words on the web page, I knew that I could change them. And that right there was just enough for me to start telling everybody that I know that I can hack websites. Now, I don't go on to learn C++ at the age of 12 after this. I actually just forget. It's 2014 now, I'm 16, and I'm an even bigger dick. I started wearing Sperry's and dress shirts to fit in with the preppy kids at school. My dream at the time was to join a frat in college and become friends with very rich kids. But that dream came quickly to an end when I didn't score high on my SATs, so I couldn't get into the top colleges. This is where one day after complaining in bio class, my friend Cole tells me, "Just go to college for computer science. You'll make a ton of money." Now, computer science didn't sound all that fun to me at the time. But later that night, I went home and I found Code Academy. Now, you might be thinking, Code Academy, big deal. But at the time, all the resources of today did not exist. Code Academy was the end-all be-all for learning to code online for free. Instead of hanging out with friends, I would come home from school, put my headphones in, and take online web development courses. I learned a lot quickly, and I felt like I was learning a lot quickly. People underestimate how easy it is to get started coding. When you actually take the time to learn a little bit, and you're learning web development, you'll see visible changes with each line of code. Now at the time, I can't remember if I cared more about learning or just feeling like I was smart.
And for the last few years, my research team at Canisius College has been attaching sensors and wireless transmitters to sneakers so that you can move and make music.
This was the very first project I worked on in college. Now, technically, I didn't really contribute much because I was just a freshman at the time. But even just hanging around the robotics club and watching this project come to fruition was pretty inspiring for me. Classes at the time were pretty easy because I had already learned about basic programming. My very first semester in college, I got straight A's, and that led to me becoming a computer science tutor. Ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Now, in life, what you'll learn is there's ups and downs, and during the ups, everything seems to be coming together. That was 2017. You see, I noticed early on, from looking at other people's LinkedIn profiles, that if you got a good internship, you're probably going to go on to have a very successful career in tech. So I got to work. I built this extremely complicated iOS app, using Swift, Firebase, and a bunch of APIs. while simultaneously taking discrete math, large-scale programming, distributed computing, and algorithms. Java, Swift, APIs, Google Firebase, Xcode storyboards, layout patterns that I don't remember, basic UI UX design using Adobe Creative Cloud applications like Photoshop and Illustrator. I got the student plan, it was only 20 bucks a month. But what was all of this hard work leading up to?
Live emergency press conference. Within the next 6 months to 8 months, all of Barstool Sports will be relocating to Manhattan.
I messaged the head engineer of Barstool Sports on LinkedIn, and he just said I could come and intern. Now, I think there were like 15,000 people trying to intern at the time, and somehow I was like one of 15 selected. I got to work on a scrum team with some pretty talented engineers, and we were migrating the entire site over to React.js. By the end of the internship, I'd learned a lot about full stack development, and even some basic data science.
And not only that, but this internship really gave me an idea of what the actual tech industry is like.
I can't even begin to stress how awesome this summer was. I was 20 years old working with the best engineers in an upcoming company that everyone thinks is cool as shit, while living at Columbia University, where all of my sweet mates were rich kids that threw parties all of the time.
But just like everything else, the summer eventually came to an end, and it was time to go home.
I want to know who motherfucking representing it here tonight.
In 2018, I got a little bit carried away. How can I explain
myself? You said you care for me. Louisiana shit. Murder on the beat. Something for y'all to cut up to, you know? Yeah. Everybody get your motherfucking roll on. I know shorty and she doesn't want no slow song. Had a man last year, life goes on. Haven't let the thing loose, girl, in so long. You been inside, know you.
Recapping this year in 30 seconds is nearly impossible, but I'm gonna do my best. I did 2 semesters of college at different colleges. I did robotics research with Ross, and I built a grading software to help my school go paperless. I started a company that was entered into Launch New York, but the company ended over business disagreements. I got mentorship from this 16-year-old kid who made a viral app and Facebook offered him a job, and then he did a bunch of stuff and became an executive, kind of a weird scenario. Basically, he was younger than me and teaching me stuff. I did independent consulting for his consulting company for like 9 months and worked on a bunch of different projects. I did computer science and astrophysics research on gravitational waves. I made a bunch of friends and got to work with really smart people, and I was a part of this very prestigious organization called LIGO. I didn't know anything about astrophysics, so it was hard, and it was machine learning, and it was C programming, and we were working with supercomputers. It was weird. I did 3 different hackathons, the first one I lost, the second 2 I won awards at. And then at this time, before I started posting my coding videos, I started streaming coding, live coding constantly, over on twitch.tv. So obviously I can go into a bunch of detail on each of these things, but I don't have the time. Time is an, we don't have it. Let's, 2019, let's go. It was my last year of college, and I was feeling this pressure to get into Google. Now, a lot of people that work at Google have really impressive backgrounds, so I also wanted to take on a lot of projects, once again, at the same time. The first thing I did that year was reach out to a local cryptocurrency startup company where I would work probably around 20 hours a week, and it was a pretty cool group of guys, and I really enjoyed my time there. While I was working there, I started my YouTube journey with no subscribers at the time, maybe like 100. I also think I was going through the Google interview process while I was there. If any of you have interviewed at Google, you know this is a very long and tedious process and could go on for months. You guys might be familiar with this part of the story. As I was studying, I started doing LeetCode problems. Somehow I became a software developer for this company in Syracuse where I was working on iOS and Android mobile applications for security companies, security software. I also did web development, web applications for some security software. It's kind of strange, but I worked at the Buffalo Bills, an NFL company, with their data. The whole team did like data analytics, but I worked on a mobile onboarding application for the team, like the players. Throughout all of this, I'm still in the Google interview process. I passed, and the hiring managers passed me. And at a certain point, I have a video on this, but it all fell apart. And then at one point when all this was going on, I reached out to a friend of mine, and we started a company. Our logo is literally a chode. But it was called AgendaV. We made a website. We had a bank account. We made an LLC. We did all this crap. We went on Upwork and PeoplePerHour and freelancing websites, and we got all these clients, and it was really exciting, and we were making thousands of dollars. But eventually my business partner was like, I actually don't want to do a coding company. And I was like, all right, well, whatever. We canceled it. After getting rejected from Google, I guess I could have proceeded to continue my company by myself, but I didn't find that very fun. I want to work with people. So I was like, all right, I got to get a legit job. Let's figure this out. And I got an offer for like $115,000 to go to San Francisco. And we did this contract period and this trial thing. And I went there and I did that, and my YouTube was less than a few thousand subscribers, but while I was there, it just started blowing up like crazy. So during this trial period with that company, I ended up deciding I don't necessarily want to do this. I want to pursue YouTube. I thought it was a good opportunity at the time. A lot of people were taking advantage. You know, I think it's a good thing that I did do YouTube because it's led to even more opportunities, and you know, it's hard to get in now. I think it's very oversaturated, and I think I made a really good decision at the time. So I decided to go home and pursue YouTube. I kept doing YouTube, and now here we are. We have a bunch of subscribers. So good thing I did that. So we all know what happened in 2020 and 2021. The world is obviously a mess. I wanted to become very big on YouTube, like a big YouTube person. I think I could still do that, although I wish I would have done it last year. The problem is I kind of wanted to get a group of people together and have a house, which I tried multiple times at multiple different houses, who would all work hard and help each other and film content, but it didn't necessarily work out like that. I've realized now that the only person I can rely on for my YouTube success is me. Now this is of course 10 years of coding, not 10 years of YouTube, so I will say that I did work with some local companies from New York while I was living in Las Vegas on some projects. I did program somewhat, but I didn't put these on my resume. They weren't that big of a deal, kind of just helping companies out. And then of course after teaching so many coding interviews, I was offered a contract from Algo Expert. I'm sure you guys got an ad before this video about passing your coding interviews. And I currently still work with Algo Expert to this day. Now, if there wasn't a pandemic going on and if I didn't have asthma, I probably would be doing so many different things right now, and the economy would be great and life would be great and everything would be awesome and I would be prospering and being very successful. But unfortunately, a lot of horrible things are happening around the world, and it does affect me as far as motivation and career-wise. I do kind of miss walking to places, going somewhere, having a place to be, meeting up with other people, sharing thoughts and ideas. It's not as easy anymore working from home, and I hope it gets back to normal at some point so I can continue my journey, because I'd love to, work and code and all that stuff, and coding is good, and fuck. I just want to end this video by wrapping up. Like, I worked on so many things at the same time, all the time. I was trying to get new things and do new things because I kind of wanted to experience everything that I could to determine, hey, what do I want to do? And what I've determined is I still don't know. Yes, I think it's important to work with cool technologies and work on cutting edge things that doesn't like inspire you and motivate you and you're working on something cool. But really what's motivated me the most is the people I've gotten to work with. So working with smart, cool people that you get along with, and like those are the best work environments I've had, some of the best times of my life. So it's really more important to me in life than prestige or respect or the money or the bling. It's just the people and the experiences and having a good time. If you're new here and you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. And I appreciate everyone for watching. Comment below if you have thoughts, and I'll talk to you guys. Otherwise, follow me on social media, all of that stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.